Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today I will show you an idea. A game between world champion Boris Spassky when he was only 12 years old. He played in a junior tournament against Avtonomov. The team today is playing with the isolated pawn and making the d4 d5 break. So let's look the game. Actually, it was played in Leningrad in 1949. So Spassky started with d4, black played d5, c4, queen's gambit, and black accepted it with d takes c4, knight f3, knight f6, e3, c5, challenging the center, bishop takes c4, e6, castling a6. Queen e2. As you see, white already has some development advantage, developed 3 pieces plus castled, black developed only 1 piece. b5, bishop b3, knight c6, knight c3. And here black need to be careful, and he made a mistake because white developed 4 pieces plus castled, black developed only 2 pieces. So means like 5 versus 2. That's kind of a big development advantage, and also the black king is still in the middle. So in this type of position, black should try to go for quick development and try to castle. Something like maybe bishop b7, rook d1, bishop e7. And try to keep the position close. That's another important idea for black here to follow, to keep his king safe. d takes c5 maybe. Queen c7 to save the queen, e4, bishop takes c5. And probably this is a playable position for black. Instead of that, he captured on d4 with the idea of creating a passed pawn. Maybe try to attack it, but this was a bad idea, because white played rook d1, pinning the pawn, ready to recapture with his own pawn. And I think this was the last moment where black could play still to survive. It was really important to quickly develop and be ready to castle. Bishop d6, e takes d4, knight a5 to go for the bishop. Bishop g5, castle d5. So black need to eliminate that strong bishop, and white captures back, and still white is better here because his rook is already on the d5, putting pressure on the bishop and the queen. The g5 bishop is also attacking and pinning the f6 knight. So white is better, but as you see, black already castled, so he may have some chances to survive. Instead, black just continued his original plan to develop the queen side and try to actually play against the isolated pawn. Bishop b7, a takes d4, knight b4. So black continues with his plan with the idea of playing knight b to d5 and try to block this pawn. And then if he could manage to do that, then black will be fine. But as we see, white has some big development advantage, and the black king is still in the middle, so in this type of position you try to shoot for the attack, even by sacrifices. You should try to open up the position and be aggressive before the opponent can develop. So d5, white wants to open the files to attack the king and the queen. Knight b takes d5, bishop g5 pinning the knight. Actually, the f6 knight is also pinned, the d5 knight is also pinned, so white is ready to win material. Bishop e7 is the only move to block the e file. This way, the e6 pawn is not pinned anymore, so you can recapture on d5. Bishop takes f6, destroying the king's position. g takes f6. If black would capture with the bishop, that would open up the e5, so after bishop takes d5, bishop takes d5, knight takes d5, black e6 pawn cannot take back on d5, so white is winning because has an extra piece. So g takes f6 was necessary. But the knight takes d5, bishop takes d5, bishop takes d5, forcing the black pawn to capture on d5 and open up the e-file, knight d4. Certainly knight c6 forking the bishop and the queen, plus knight f5. f5 square is very weak. King f8, if castling, then knight c6 double attack, wins the piece, the check. So king f8 was instead played, knight f5, h5. And here white has a very powerful move. Please stop the video and try to find the solution. So white plays rook takes d5, winning a pawn, actually winning back the pawn, plus removing the defender of the e7 bishop. Actually, probably black should have played here, maybe queen e8 or queen c7, but he captured the rook. But here white just goes for the king. Queen takes e7 check, king g8, queen takes f6 with a double attack on checkmate on g7 or knight e7, forking the king and the queen. So after this move, black resigned. So the most important idea of this game is, if you have development advantage and the opponent king is in the middle, try to exchange the center pawns to open up the files for your major pieces to attack the opponent king. I wish you can use these ideas in your own games. Thank you for watching and see you soon in another video. Bye bye.